Danny Flexen here, 4 seconds out. Delighted to be joined by the British middleweight champion, Denzel Bentley. Denzel, how are you doing?
I'm good, thanks. I'm good.
Oh,
thanks. I don't think I was introducing me that yet. You know, they just say, Denzel Bentley. Maybe they have actually. Maybe I'm bugging. Maybe not front on the bus. How you doing?
But maybe I should have put a bit more emphasis on it. You know, I've never done any MC work, but yeah, maybe in the future. Is it starting to sink in now? Obviously, not only have you been British champion for a while, you've been over to Ghana as well, been well received over there for your achievements. Do you feel like the British champion now?
Yeah, it's fully sunk in now. I do feel that. You know, British champion, I feel like I'm, you know, I deserve that title as well. So it's there now.
Has it made any change in terms of how you approach your work in the gym? Do you go in with kind of extra impetus now, extra enthusiasm for your work?
Yeah, I think mentally it's kind of switched me on a little bit more. It's made me feel like I'm there now. You know what I'm going to say? I'm with the big boys now. So I've got to put in that little bit more effort. I think mentally I'm just putting in that extra and all the work, doing everything that got me to this level and more, really. Like, when people are coming up for sparring, it's like, all right, don't let them get one up on you, because they're not just getting one up on you, they're getting one up on the British champion. I'm saying, you can't afford that. So, yeah.
Do you get the feeling it works in the same way on the people that come up to spar you, that they've got more, you know, determination, more incentive to perform well in sparring because of who they're going up against?
Yeah, 100%, 100%. I'm sure they'll be getting told, listen, you're going up against the British champion, so just make sure you're on your A game, blah, 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 all them kind of things. Because I was coming up in the game and I was sparring a potential British champion or a British champion. I'm like, all right, cool, you got to be, you know, fully awake here, otherwise this guy's going to ping you about. So I guess it helps everyone up their levels. So, yeah, it's good.
And who have you been sparring in the last kind of few weeks? Because you've only got, 12 days to go now till the fight. I imagine you haven't got long left of sparring now. But who have you been doing some of your work with?
I've sparred a load of people, you know. It's kind of long to go through names, to be honest, but I sparred quite a lot of people, I'm not going to lie. I've done some rounds with... I don't want to miss anyone out as well, because it's kind of rude, so I'm not going to say no names, because I've done rounds with a lot of people.
No, that's fair enough. The first defence is on the 24th of April, so not long to wait now, against Felix Cash, Commonwealth champion, of course. Were you surprised, first of all, that the fight came together? Because I know there was a lot of talk about him potentially going another route. His trainer was talking about him going for the European instead.
Yeah, you know what? I always felt like if he was going to go another route, it wouldn't be any fault of his own. I felt like his team would have directed him another route, but he just, you know, showed me that, you know, he's earned my respect by turning around to his team and saying, no, I want that fight because he wants to be a British champion. So, like I said, I've said it a few times, I respect him for doing that as well, because, like you said, he didn't need to. Could have went the European route and tried to, you know, skip stages and stuff. But listen, credit where credit's due, took the fight. But it's on now. It's looking like his, you know, it is on. It's not looking like it's on. You know what I'm saying? We've got like less than a week. Well, just over a week, sorry. Less than 2 weeks to go. And then we're there, really. So, yeah, man.
As first defences go, it's pretty much as tough as you could get in the British middleweight division. There's no voluntary. It's a mandatory. And he's the Commonwealth champion as well. So it's and he's unbeaten.
Yeah, the thing is, I knew that before winning the title. So they said, you know, the winner of this fight's Felix Cash. I said, let's go then, isn't it? I guess I'm fighting Felix Cash because that's whose name they put out there. But I wouldn't have it any other way, because I'm a guy that wants to move forward. You've known me for a while now. We talk off camera. You've been interviewing me for a while, and I've always said it. You always ask me who you calling out, who you looking for. I've always said the guys that are up there. So now I'm up there. I got to face who's at this level. So I wouldn't have it any other way. I wouldn't want to just fight someone that's a gimme fight, because that's not a fight that's going to move me forward. This fight's going to move me forward. I want every fight here and that to take me another step closer to what I want to achieve, which is a world title. So if it's not going to do that, then really and truly it's pointless. I know sometimes now and then you might need a little squeeze, a little, you know, not easy fight, but because no fight is easy, but just not as hard. But at the end of the day, it's I need meaningful fights. Now, I've had enough of these, you know, fights that don't do nothing for me, like learning fights and stuff. I just need a bit more meaningful fights.
And with that in mind, what do you feel he brings to the table? You know, without giving away your game plan or anything like that, what do you feel are his key strengths?
No, I ain't got a game plan. No, I'm playing.
He's gonna wing it.
He's a good fighter. He's a good fighter. That's about all I can say. I'm not gonna say, oh, he does this, he does that. He's a good fighter, and he does, you know, does a lot of things good. That's why he is where he is. That's why he's Commonwealth champion, isn't it? So I'm not going to go in there thinking, oh, this is you know, a walkover fight. It's not. He's a good fighter, and so was Mark, and I still managed to step up to the plate and come up with a W. So I'm expecting the same thing on the 24th.
When I spoke to him a few days ago, he seemed to believe experience would be a key factor in his favour, perhaps thinking about the amateur days as well as professional. What do you make of that?
Listen, Mark's been a professional longer than I've been boxing. So he could have said the same thing. It's all about, you know, who's better on the night. You can talk about experience, but at the end of the day, how much more experience does he have over me in the professional ranks? Okay, he won his title a year earlier. I don't know. I'm not quite sure how many times he's been 12 rounds, but, you know, the opponents he's fought ain't much different from the ones I fought, or not any better than the ones I fought neither. So, yeah, you can talk about amateur experience, but amateur's only 3 rounds. So unless his experience is going to carry him 3 rounds, then whatever, innit? Like, he is a good fighter, so it is what it is. But I just think I'm better. Yeah, experience can play a factor, but I think I gained enough experience from the first Mark Heffron fight. You know, I learned a lot from that, but we'll see on the 24th anyway.
Are you relieved in any sense that Matchroom didn't win the purse bids and you weren't forced to go on to a Matchroom show? I'm not alleging anything at all, but there's been a few, you know, contentious decisions in UK rings recently, not just on Matchroom shows, I should emphasise. But as someone who's affiliated with Frank Warren, as pretty much always in the last few years at least fought on their shows, would you have been a bit, not reluctant, but would you have been a bit wary about going on to another promoter show?
I was ready to go wherever, because if I didn't go on that show, I'd have to vacate my title. So I wasn't worried about anything. I was ready to go wherever. Like you said, I'm happy Frank won the purse bid, not because of that reason. I'm happy Frank won the purse bids. No matter where the fight would happen, I would have fought. But I'm happy Frank won the purse because it made me feel like he believes in me more and he's willing to back me and push me. So that's the only reason why I'm happy Frank won the purse bid, because even if Eddie won it and it was on a matching show and all of these things, we're still in a ring with no crowd. So it doesn't really make a difference. You know what I mean? I'll still have to fight. Yeah, it probably makes it a little bit better that, you know, it's on a home show, but I'm comfortable wherever I go. I'm just happy Frank won it, because it just shows me that he believes in me and he's willing to push me. That's my main reason for being happy.
Is it a more prominent fight, the fact that it's on a Frank Warren show? Will it be given more prominent attention? Because on a Matchroom show, you would imagine it might be a chief support rather than a main event, for example.
Yeah, probably. That's a good point. But I feel like, I don't want to say this without being, like, on the BT side of things, I'm, you know, coming up, you know, potential to do good things and stuff, where on the Sky side, it's been there for a while, and because of the role that I'm on, it's like it fits to be a main event fight, if that makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I agree. You froze a little. You didn't freeze. The screen froze for a minute there, but I think I got the gist of what you were saying, that, you know, you're more known to that BT audience, so it makes sense for you for it to be on BT, because you're the A side as well on the BT, whereas maybe Felix would have been promoted as the A side on Sky.
Yeah, exactly that as well. But like I was saying before, maybe when it froze, but like, my growth has been a bit more rapid on this side because of, you know, how quickly I've come through the tests that they've been giving me. Whereas on the Sky side, he hasn't grown as rapidly as maybe he expected to. So it just makes more sense to be a headline on BT because of, you know, the rapid pace. Because like you said, the A side, B side stuff, but, you know, they're promoting it around me.
And what's the plans for the future? I know you don't want to look too far beyond what is a really, really good fight on the 24th of April, but you must have plans. You said about you want to take meaningful fights to get you on that road towards a world title. Do you see yourself going via the European route, as Felix was talking about before this fight, or a fringe kind of IBF, WBA type thing?
The European route would be nice, you know, just going that traditional route, British, Commonwealth, European. It's always nice to win that, you know what I'm saying? Especially all three at the same time and stuff. But whatever opportunity presents itself after this, you know, the fringe world level stuff is kind of nice as well. It is good. It lets you know that you're hanging with guys that's been in there with world champions or former world champions, or maybe even a former world champion on the slide. It just lets you know that you're in the mix now. I'm ranked quite high with the WBO, ranked number 9. So it's possible. It's possible to get one of those fights, you know, because it's a world ranking. I'm sure anyone would want, you know, a world ranking. So if it's based off that, then someone might be like, okay, no, I can take his ranking if I fight him and stuff. So whichever opportunity presents itself, but like you were saying, I've got to get through cash, otherwise none of this matters. So yeah, it's tunnel vision.
Now, before I let you go, the week before your fight, there's a big world middleweight title fight in the US, and it's for the WBO title, which you've just mentioned,
yeah,
number 9 in their ranking. So it's pertinent to ask you, how do you see the fight between Demetrius Andrade and Liam Williams going?
I see Andrade winning, but it's a closer fight than I expected it to be the first time around hearing it. Do you know what I mean? Because first time around, I just thought, oh, Williams is going to get slapped about here, but... As it's gone on and I've, you know, kind of sat down and analysed the fight, because I like doing that. I like trying to break it down and see, okay, who's actually favourite here? I still got Andrade as favourite, but I think Williams has a much better chance than I actually gave him the first time. Because you look at the records, apart from the losses to Liam Smith, there isn't anyone on Andre's record that Williams wouldn't beat. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Who's the best person on Andre's record? What's that? Atlantis Fox, maybe?
Selecki? There must be someone better than that. Jack Colquhoun, that's quite a good name.
Yeah, Beating him over
in Germany, I think that was a good result. Willie Nelson,
remember that, yeah, over Germany, yeah.
Win, but probably not the biggest name.
Yeah, but I think Williams would probably do well against those guys too. Do you know what I'm trying to say? It'd probably beat them. I think at 160, he is a different fighter than he was at 154. So everyone, you know, Andre is beat at 160, I should say. Williams would be at 162. Okay. So it's a closer fight. It's definitely a closer fight than I expected it to be. But if you're just looking at their styles and, you know, who they both are, I think Andre's got more to his game. He's got longer reach, taller fighter. He'll probably sit there and try and throw big shots at times, which might not help him because it might fall into Williams's hand, you know, coming forward and trying to just land big shots. But I haven't seen Andre go down or be knocked out or be hurt or anything. So it's hard to kind of picture a man losing that hasn't lost. So I'm just going to side of Andre, but I think Williams has a good chance. If he could do it, that'd be good for everyone in the country.
So visualise this. You retain your title against Felix Cash. Liam Williams has upset the odds and your prediction and beaten Demetrius Andrade for the title. And Frank Warren gives you a ring or gives your manager a ring and says, right, Denzel, you and Liam in the summer, main event, decent money. World title shot. Would you take it this early in your career?
What kind of question is that? Of course I would. Of course I would. That's a perfect route to whatever. That's like a perfect plan. Like both fight around the same time, both win. What else is there to make? Apart, unless, you know, he wants to unify our sign. Let's have an easy defense. Come on, earn a bit of money. Let's have an easy defense. And then you see me raise my hand with a world title. Fucking, that's a dream come true. But listen, that's all just thinking and dreaming. It would be lovely, you know, to go that way, but can't overlook what I've got in front of me. So, tunnel vision, like I said.
Fair enough. Well, I'm sorry for trying to tempt you off the righteous path. Let's talk again in 2 weeks and see where we are.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, great stuff. Very best of luck, obviously, for the 24th. I'm looking forward. It's going to be a great fight. I can't wait to watch it.
Nice one.
And yeah, we'll speak again after the fight.
No, nice one. Thanks.
Cheers, Denzel. Take care.
Take care. All right. All right. Bye.